Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I'm Devinta Irenoviati from Irlanda University. Today I would like to present about severe COVID-19 pneumonia confirmed with massive pleural effusion and detection of tuberculosis pleurisy by ADA test. Radiology evaluation is also very necessary while waiting for the result of the RT-PCR. In the early stage of COVID-19, white patches and interstitial change in the peripheral lung severe cases, SARS-CoV pneumonia may have consolidation, but pleural effusion are rare. Pascal Lomoro et al. From 27 patients, there's no pleural effusion, and Gileta Kozi et al. From 135 patients, is only 60.6% pleural effusion. SARS-CoV-2 patients with pleural effusion have low prevalence, and in this case, that man had confirmed with SARS-CoV-2 pneumonia, and his XR saw a unilateral massive pleural effusion. From medical history, a 26 years old man with the main complaint of shortness of breath, fever, cough, nausea, and vomiting. There was also coughing of blood, diarrhea, decrease of weight, and sore throat. The patient has a history of alcohol and drug consumption, history of other disease and consumption of anti-tuberculosis drugs denied. From physical examination, it increment of the heart rate, respiratory rate, and the saturation only 87% in pre-care. In the left side of the chest, is difficult to rise. This is the hematology examination. We can find in the first admittance, there were increment of white blood cell and the other parameters with the normal limit, and also increment of neutrophil lymphocyte ratio. This is the table 2 is clinical chemistry and immunology examination. There were also decrement of albumin serum and increment of IST, ILT, CRP, procalcitonin, and ferritin. From the coagulation studies in the first admittance, there were increment of the dimer until the treatment, and PPT, IPT, fibrinogen was within normal limit. This is the pleural fluid analysis examination. In this examination, we can find that increment of the parameter of glucose, protein, and also LDH. Based on the increase in the three parameters, is met the light criteria to be classified as an exudate fluid. The result of SARS-CoV-2 antibody showed that IgG and IgM was reactive, and also PCR SARS-CoV-2 was positive. In the blood gas analysis, there were decrement of PS, increment of PCO2, and also increment of bicarbonate. So the conclude is respiratory acidosis with compensatory metabolic alkalosis. From the chest X-ray, we can find in the first time patient admission in chest X-ray show that the equation of miliary tuberculosis in the lung with bilateral pleural effusion, but left more massive. And then in 5 September, the patient was carried out with pleural fluid tapping, and about 850 milliliter of pleural fluid came out, and then the pleural fluid analysis was performed, and then the second fluid evacuation in 10 September. In 16 September, there was reduced impression of pleural effusion, but in 21 September, there was increased pleural effusion was found. This is the blood, sputum, and urine culture. In the culture examination, we have obtained the positive result on the examination of the fungal culture from sputum is Candida tropicalis, and from the pleural fluid culture is Pseudomonas diminuta. The acid phase stain is no bacteria. The patient was examined for other tests to determine the causes of the pleural effusion, and the test result so high. This is from the clinical symptoms, examination, and also the laboratory result. So the patient patient diagnosed with severe COVID-19 pneumonia with massive pleural effusion and tuberculosis pleurisy. This is the therapy given by clinician. The plan is patient given OAT therapy based on the result of the other test. According to WHO, the severity of COVID-19 is divided into mild, moderate, and severe. And the severe category is the clinical sign where found is fever, cough, shortness of breath, more than 30 times per minute of respiratory rate, and under 90% in the air. The patient also has the shortness of breath, fever, coughing, and also decrement of saturation, and PCR COVID was positive. So it fulfilled criteria for severe pneumonia and COVID-19. SARS-CoV-2 attached to the angiotensin converting enzyme 2 or S2 receptor, and it may cause a decrease in number of CD4, CD8, and B cells. So there's the picture of lymphopenia and increase in the number of neutrophils. This patient has increased in NLR. NLR over 3.30 is prognosis that lead to worsening. Coagulopathy in COVID-19 is also show the prolongation of PTA-PTT increase of the dimer, fibrinogen, and FDP. But in this patient had increased only the dimer. This was due to the involvement of pro-inflammatory cytokine during the endothelial injury that triggered activation of coagulation inhibitor. Increasing AST and ALT level in this patient because of SARS-CoV-2 can directly bind to H2 content in cholangiocyte. Attachment causes cholangiocyte dysfunction and systemic inflammation that induce liver damage, and this also decrease in albumin. Elevated level of several inflammatory biomarker, it can make CRP, procalcitonin, LDH, and also ferritin is increased. From chest radiograph, in the severe COVID-19 pneumonia can be consolidated, but the picture of pleural effusion is very rare. So this patient has a picture of massive pleural effusion. This finding doesn't support the picture of COVID-19, therefore finding the causes of the pleural effusion is needed for the diagnosis. From the light criteria is fulfilled from the exudate. The exudate result on the pleural analysis due to the presence of parapneumonia, like empyema and tuberculosis. And pleural fluid culture, we can find that Pseudomonas pneumonata was found, a gram-negative bacterium, rod-shaped, and cocci. And the patient has been given appropriate treatment with antibiotic sensitive, but the pleural effusion is not improving. So for the investigation, we're carried out to determine the cause of the origin of pleural infection. The patient was examining the adaptase. We know that adaptase is sensitivity with high sensitivity and specificity to establish the TB pleurisy, and the patient is then and the level the adaptase level patient was 43. So from the examination, the patient conclude the pleural effusion causes by TB pleurisy. Severe pneumonia with persistent pleural effusion and tuberculosis pleurisy are rare. Severe pneumonia related by physical examination, shortness of breath, and also increment of many laboratory is so that there was hyperinflammatory process. The diagnosis of TB pleurisy is based on the radiological examination, pleural fluid analysis, and other examination. Pleural effusion is COVID-19 patient very rare. Thinking holistically and carrying out appropriate investigation. Examination of the adaptase at the beginning of the patient found a pleural effusion can be considered while waiting for the result of the culture to consider offering appropriate therapy. Thank you.